So we can also do our frequency stuff in histograms. Histograms, like I said before, it's a bar graph that has no gaps. The width of each bar is equal to how much information you're keeping in there. So in our example before, when we were just did a bar graph of 10, 11, 12, 13, the width of those ones would be 1 if we made a histogram, because we only included one value. But if we wanted to look at things between 1 and 3, between 3 and 5, like we're going to do in the next example, then our width of our bar is going to be 2. So we're going to learn how to do this on our calculator as well. And the x-axis is always the topic of the data, and your y-axis is always your frequency. And again, every time you make a graph, you are going to have to label those things and label them clearly. Put an x along your x-axis, a y along your y-axis, label what they stand for. And here is the information for how to write it on your calculator. We're going to go through this so that if there's any things on here that you're wondering how or what that meant, then you can come back to this video and explore that. So here is our first example. We've got a histogram and we've got frequencies there for ages of 270 people in a village. So the first thing here is, are we able to interpret the data? So between the ages of 0 and 20, right, the mid value there is 10, and the frequency is 40. So the next one, the mid value is 30, and frequency is 70, mid value is 50, and the frequency is 100. Between 60 and 80, it's 50. And between 80 and 100 is 10. Now, if you added up those frequencies, they add up to 270, because there was 270 people in the village. The interval width of all of them is 20. So we don't know the exact mean age. We don't know the exact average because we've grouped people together, right? It would make a difference. There's 40 people between the ages of 0 and 20. Maybe they're all 18-year-olds. Probably not. That would be kind of interesting if a village only had 18-year-olds between the ages of 0 and 20. Chances are that they're spread out. So what statistics is saying that we're going to say that the average age between 0 and 20 is probably 10. The average age of all the people between 20 and 40 is probably 30. But that's not going to be perfectly accurate, because we know that that doesn't happen all the time. But it might be somewhat accurate, especially between the ages of 80 and 100. We might start to think, well, probably the average age isn't 90. It probably would be closer to 80 than it would be to 100. But anyways, what we can do with this is we can calculate an estimate. Again, how do we calculate an average? We add up all the ones that we have and then divide by the total number. So all the ones that we have, well, we have 40 people at age 10, 70 people at age 30, 100 people at age 50, another 50 people at age 70, and finally 10 people at age 90. That whole thing divided by the 270 people in the village. and quickly typing that in. And here, I'm going to 3 sig figs. Here's my estimate. My number on my calculator said 44.07. So to 3 sig figs, I have 44.1. Again, using the approximation sign as a result of that. Well, it is an age you can be, you know, half a year. Could be closer to 45 than 44. And so we will go to 3 sig figs in that sort of thing. It does tell us that it's a little bit over 44, not just 44. But, you know, for certain studies, right, this is the kind of thing where would it make sense to put 44 there as an average age? Yes. Right, if you were writing a paper about it, it would tell you the same sort of thing. If you say 44.1, what you're doing at that point is you're letting the reader know that you did some more math. It wasn't just, I kind of figured it out. It kind of gives more validity to it, and so that might be helpful.